Greetings, dear viewers. This is the Couch Warrior. Welcome to Chapter 2 of the Book of Sable. Just a couple of announcements. I had some technical problems with a saved game that have caused me to record this video having completed probably half of Bleak Falls Barrow. My only option if I were to recover the entire thing would have been to go back and play through Helgen again. It didn't seem like, didn't seem worth it to do that. So what I've done is basically started out at the beginning here. I'm going to walk through so you get a sense for how far through this I am. At this point, I've encountered three bandits, a giant spider, a few skeevers, and cut a guy out of a spider web who is stuck down here. He had the golden claw that we were after. Just in the interest of catching everyone up, when we left Chapter 1, I was on my way to Riverwood, having just escaped Helgen. I went to Riverwood and got the help of Gerder. I went and raided Gerder's house and basically got all the supplies I could carry, sold much of that at the Riverwood Trader, and then was introduced to the Bretons that ran the Riverwood Trader, and they had just had a golden claw stolen from them by these bandits. Given the fact that they were Bretons and friendly faces, fellow Bretons, I guess, the first I've seen in Skyrim, I elected to go ahead and help them recover it. I'm also, you know, really hurting for cash at this point. So I entered Bleak Falls Barrow. I fought the bandits outside. I fought some bandits inside. I fought some skeevers here. Made it to the point where I recovered the golden claw, and that's where I'm going to pick up this adventure. Again, I apologize for losing some content here, but you know what? This is a new endeavor for me, and I'm working the kinks out, so you're going to basically see my playthrough warts and all. Here is the spider. I polished him off. Then here is where the guy was stuck. I cut him out, and he ran away from me, trying to escape with the golden claw. I followed him through here and took him out right here. So this is essentially where we're picking it up. I have not progressed any further through Bleak Falls Barrow than this point. So again, I apologize for missing some content here, but I certainly appreciate you sticking with me. After all, this is only episode number 4. So we'll complete Bleak Falls Barrow and we'll see where the adventure takes us. As I had mentioned in my last installment, I was going to go to live commentary here for Chapter 2, and that's exactly what I've done. I'm doing this commentary live. I'm going to go to the hunting bow here. I can see a draugr laying there. He looks like he's going to be trouble, so I'm going to attempt to take him out right now instead of giving him the chance of messing with me. At this point, I have also reached, there's another one, I've also reached level 3. So I actually, once I started taking on bandits and so forth in the first part of Bleak Falls Barrow, levels started coming fast. So at this point I've hit level 3. One more shot. Okay. See his buddy. What's he gonna do? Perfect. Look at that. Trap took him out for us. I love that. Take that necklace. So, okay, yeah. We gotta watch out for that pressure plate. At this level, that thing will take me out in one shot. Little refresher. My objective here is to build a character who's going to be primarily a mage. I'm going to go to the arrows. I'm going to go to the sword if I feel the need to. In these instances, at low level, if I can use the bow and get a jump on a draugr, I'm going to do that. I don't have a lot of spells right now that are terrific range weapons, so... These guys are hard to hit when they're laying down. Yeah, there we go, there's a hit. Come on. Follow me, dude. Come on. Come on. Right there. Oh. I think I waited a little too long before I went to spells there. I was kind of hoping he'd run over that trap and it would spring on him, but it didn't. I'm not sure why. He ran right over the pressure plate. Let's try this again. Let's try a different strategy this time. Let's do what we can to work on the mage skills. That's what we're supposed to be all about here anyway. So, see what happens. Let this guy get close. Gotta recover some magicka. Well, let's keep drawing him along. We're pecking away at him, right? There we go. Oh, nothing like a fighting retreat. Saves my bacon every time. Recover some magicka here. You know, one of the things that I do have, I think, in my inventory are some mage robes I picked up in Helgen. Imagine I could change novice robes. Magicka regenerates 50% faster. Let's have a look. Now, that's probably going to help me if I'm going this route, right? I may as well do it. One of the things that has kind of stopped me from doing a pure mages in the past is just how slow the leveling goes sometimes. So I've decided with this character, whenever I can, I'm gonna try to train between levels. Right now at low level, because I really haven't gone anywhere in particular, training is not available to me, but I'm gonna try to get up to the mage college as soon as I possibly can. That's really what Sable is all about anyway, acquisition of knowledge and learning more about magic. Maybe I should take that armor, huh? Is it worth anything? Yeah. As long as I'm not encumbered, why not? If I do that, then I've got lots of access to training, and that may have to be the best option for me. So, ideally, between each level, I would train in something. Bud, we gotta hit that trap. Gotta hit that trap. Come on now. Come on. No! Woo! Potions! Potions! Oh, God. Maybe I'll goose the magicka while I'm at it. Run, 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 run. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, yeah. Whew. That was a little too close. Nothing else? Alright. Let's have a look here at destruction. Shock damage to health and magicka. 8 points per second. Targets on fire take extra damage. I think flames is still my best bet against these Draugr. I don't know. Do these restless Draugr who cast at you these cold spells and stuff? I mean, I don't know. Do they have reservoirs of magic I can deplete with shock spells? I really never considered that. There's going to be more down here. I just don't know how many. Take it. I'm done. Okay. Oh, here he comes. Let's see if this guy can go through the trap. Come on. Come on in there. Do it. Bam. Nice. I'll take whatever victory I can get, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Now I gotta not step on it myself. That would be bad. Oh, shit. Yeah! Whoa! Come on. Close it. Come on. Get on it. Bam! Oh, I'm so sorry. You ran over your own trap, sir. Okay, this bow, does this do more than my hunting bow? It does. 1 point. The arrows do more too, don't they? Oh, they do. All right. I'll take that too. Okay. Moving right along. What you got? Anything? Take it. Is there anything up here? It's gotta be something. Jump! Chest! Try this. Whoop! Wrong way. Oh! There we go. Please be something good! Well, that's good. Yeah, that's good, sure. Every once in a while, at the beginning, you run into some real nice magic item. It doesn't happen that often, but every once in a while, something useful comes up. Potions are always useful, but I'm talking about, you know, maybe something like an interesting ring or whatever. Oh, I hate these. I really do. And go. And go. Oh! Get. Alright. We are going to deactivate that baby in the event that I need to make another fighting retreat. I really don't want to retreat into blades if I can help it. Let's see. You know what? We'll save a little time. All right. Keep that in mind. That could be useful, right? Little clay pot of napalm, whatever that is. Ah, see, I see you. How close can I get before I blow my cover? I'm gonna stand in the oil and use fire. This is probably not a good idea, but I'm gonna do it anyway. That inferno. I love using the environment to my advantage when I can. Sometimes you can pull off some pretty sweet stuff, but it doesn't always work to my advantage. Sometimes I end up incinerating myself, as we saw in Helgen. I almost killed myself setting oil on fire, so... Quick point of interest. I made a few changes in my YouTube account now so I can record longer videos. I was restricting my videos initially to 15 minutes. Now I can record longer ones, I think as much as 30 minutes if I need to. So that's good. That should allow me to at least do this chapter without... Keep the heat on. Levels! I love levels. My gold too. Let's have a look. We'll put it in Magicka. That's gonna be our thing, so. Dual casting. I like the idea of more powerful. Honestly, at this level, I'm just about staying alive. So, the less dying I can do, the better. Like that. Take that. Pretty sure. Well, I know for sure I can use glowing mushrooms for fortify smithing. Not sure what else they're good for. I haven't committed that to memory, but it's going to come in handy at some point. I know that. Well, that'll be handy too. Conjure Familiar. I think this is something I get for being a Breton. I'm going to try a little of this action. See what I can do with it. Let's go get him, boy. Go. One gold. Skeever tail. Take it. I'll take just about anything at low level. Because I got nothing, man. Come on. Iron arrows? What? Who puts iron arrows in a chest? Better lock those up. They're very special iron arrows. Oh, my puppy. So, if you look in the show notes for this episode and all my previous episodes, you'll see that I've updated them to include a link to a character bio. I actually created a written character background and put it on my Tumblr site for Sable. So if you need to get caught up a little bit on what's going on with him, what his background is, and what I'm using in order to base my in-game decisions, you can review that character background. Again, there's a link in the show notes, and you'll also find, I put a little news article with a link on my Tumblr site that goes to it as well. It's, you know, about a page or so. It's a quick read, but it gives you some idea of what this character is all about and why I'm playing him the way that I am. Ouch. Ouch. That's smarted. Come on, 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 come on. Woo! That was a little too close. I think that's an example of where, you know, if I hadn't put these robes on, I would have been done. That would have been all over. I wouldn't have been regenning magicka fast enough to kill that guy. But I did. It was a smart play. Oh, come on now. No. There we go. Taking that. Iron helm. I got the capacity for it. It's actually got decent value, I suppose. All right. The Sanctum. That must be where the boss is, huh? Where to find the boss. All right. There's nothing in here I need, right? Ah, wonderful. My favorite. All right. Ready? Scorched. Scorched earth. You are done, sir. And you, sir. Where's your buddy? Somebody shot at me, right? I can see you. I can see your dot. There you are. Oh. Come on. Ow. Just enough there at the end to take him out. I don't need the bow. I'll take the arrows, the gold. Incidentally, if you didn't know already, arrows are weightless, which means They have an excellent value to weight ratio, so even if you're not interested in using a bow, you can always sell them or something. There are some arrows that aren't worth anything, but I think these might be worth something. I'll take them anyway. Certainly doesn't hurt. This pure mage action is completely new to me. It's strange for me to not have a sword in my hand or anything. Okay. Let's have a look at our claw. So it looks like a bear and a bug and an owl. I think that's a bug anyway. It looks like a firefly, right? Bear and a bug and an owl. It's pretty amazing how quickly you level up in this game at the beginning. I mean, I'm not even done with Bleak Falls Barrow, which is basically really only the second significant adventure, right? Already up to fourth level. But it gets so slow at the end, so that makes up for it. Got. Take that. Guess I'll take that. Mace of Sapping. I don't really want to use a mace, but I can disenchant it, right? Take that, take that. Lockpicks always. Soul gems, sure. Staff of Sparks. Pretty good in a pinch. Already got two hunting bows. Our first word. Power word learned. Force, unrelenting force. Yes. Go, hello. Run. Woo. Okay. Yeah. Let's make him chase us. That seems the most prudent way to go here. I'm gonna start you on fire, Mr. Overlord. What's he doing? Come on, you ugly sucker. Come on, come on. Come and get me. Let's do it. Wow, where is he going, man? Good. Looks like home plate from some Draugr stadium. Take it. Wait, Great Sword of Cold. That's enchanted, so we're taking that too. All right. Did I miss anything in here? I don't know that I did. I think I got it all. I don't really need any linen wraps, although... Value of 2 gold pieces. Man, I'm just desperate enough that I'll take them. Right, we'll take them. Let's move. Let's head out. So the deal is that I was to recover the Golden Claw and bring it back to the Riverwood Trader for a reward. So we're going to go collect that reward. Ah, are you kidding? 1 gem and I'm over? Well, let's see. I'm sure I've got all kinds of crap here I don't need. Horse hide, I'm going to keep that. Was left for the dead. Seems like bad luck to take flowers off a grave or a shrine, so we're not doing that. I'm gonna figure out where we are here. Let's check a map. Hey, what's this? Illusion? I'll take it. Is there anything else up here? Worth looking, right? Alright, down we go. Ow. Okay. Look at all these mammoth skeletons. This must be a place where the Nords ran them off a cliff, right? Hunting? Sure looks that way. Let's get ourselves back to Riverwood. Offload some junk. Make some coin. I think we have something else in our quest journal too. They want us, Girder wants us to go to Whiterun and tell the Jarl that there be dragons about. So we might have to do that as well.
I'm just a poor old woman, dear. No need to trouble yourself with me.
Indeed, you are a poor old woman. Let's look in your house. You have things in your house. Oh, you have a book in your house. Doesn't hurt to look, right? Hello. Brilliant. I'm not gonna take it. We'll just leave it.
It's tough just scraping by out here, but I make do.
Boy. Breaks my heart. Somebody's grandma's living on the streets. Oh, okay. I thought I saw somebody up here. Are you kidding? It's a scavenger guy, isn't it? All right. He sees me. Do I fight this clown? I've run into these scavenger guys before and been shocked at how difficult they were to take out, but I don't know. I mean, I've never encountered one at level 4. So maybe I take them on. Well, let's give them something to think about, huh? Come on, little wolf. You distract him. That worked out okay. Of course, I can't carry any of this crap, really, because I'm overburdened as it is. I take the arrows, I guess. He's an imposter. It's not a storm cloak. Imperial bow. Is that better than mine? It is, isn't it? Hunting bow. Wow, it's way better than the hunting bow. It's better than that, too. Okay, Mr. Scavenger. Let's take your imperial bow. And I gotta jettison something. So, let us get rid of a hunting bow. Let's do a swap. A little value there. How come these guys never carry gold? It's not very often you find dead soldiers or any soldiers for that matter that actually have gold on them. So what do you do to survive exactly? There's one. Look at that. All meals provided by your army of choice. I love how the little bunny has the power to push me off course. All right. I'm going to be a pansy. I don't want to get wet, so we're going to take the bridge. Made it. Hey, Girder. Thanks for all the stuff. All right, let's go sell some things. Make some money. Because we are poor. Need to finance our questing. Good day, sir.
The sooner you find the claw, the sooner our lives can get back to normal.
Well, sir, have some normalcy.
It. There it is! Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put this back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
400.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, let's do some business.
Thank you so much for some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
We'll see about that. Okay, weapons. What can I get rid of here? Don't want to get rid of that. The hunting bow I wanted to get rid of, right? Yeah, we don't need that. The Nord bow, I'd rather not keep it. It's ugly. The Imperial swords, iron daggers, you don't need those. Longbow, I don't need that either. Steel mace, don't need that. Woodcutter's axe I'm keeping. I always keep one of those in inventory along with a pickaxe. Never know when you're going to find something worth chopping. So I got a couple things in my inventory that are weighing me down that I will probably never use, but I want to disenchant. So I'm going to have to carry those around. Now we get to see how committed I am to my new mage lifestyle. We're getting rid of this armor. We're going full on. Hide armor. It's worth a little dough. Bracers. First thing I got, iron helmet. I'll keep the ring. I could enchant that, do something fun with it. The swords. I don't know why I have this attachment. I am having a hard time giving up the sword. Okay, let's move on to miscellaneous. Let me think about that. How much money does he have left? All right. Let's see what this gentleman has. I'm interested in spells, sir. Clairvoyance. I don't have that. A ward. Alteration. Oak flesh. That's useful. Ward. Useful. Fury. Useful. Frostbite. Don't have it. Clairvoyance. I'm not going to go the zombie route quite yet. I'm not sure how I'm feeling about that. Apparel. Robes of alteration. I'm not sure I want to specialize quite yet. Nope. Don't need it. Don't want it. Don't need that. Huh. All right. Well, got the bow. Got plenty of arrows of various types. All right, let's commit. Getting rid of the swords. I'll keep my steel dagger, right? That's a useful cooking implement for any adventurer. We'll keep it.
Till next time.
Yeah.
It's a fine day with you around.
Really? Well, thank you. Let's study. So, I picked up some new stuff. This'll be helpful. I don't use it as often as I know a lot of people do. I don't know why. I just never really think to pull out the clairvoyance to point me at my objective. I just sort of follow my quest journal and follow my markers and look at my maps. I should use it more often. Maybe I will this time around. Fury is fun. This is a good one. Ah, that felt good. Move on. I'm going to stop at the blacksmith shop real quick before we continue on. I like to take any hides or pelts that I've got laying around, convert them to leather and then into strips. They are lighter that way, easier to carry. Okay, done with that. And Sable is ready to move on. Well, thank you, dear viewers, for watching Chapter 2 of the Book of Sable. Please feel free to rate, like, and subscribe if you like this video. I would much, much appreciate it. And I look forward to seeing you all for Chapter 3.